Put some text behind a subject, but it gets harder. Here we go. Let's put this clip on the timeline, and I'm just gonna add a text on top of it. First, let's duplicate this clip. Press and hold Option key and drag the clip, and release the mouse first before you let go of the Option key. Now let's go to the effects tab, and I'm gonna type mask down here in the search box, and let's use the draw mask tool. Drag and drop the draw mask tool in the duplicate clip, and we're gonna draw a mask around this part of the girl right here where we want the text to disappear. I like to reduce the opacity of the top clip a little bit so that I can see the text behind it. For this clip, I'm gonna make sure that I get her hair right here. I even wanna maybe just zoom in a little bit. To close the mask, let's click here, and the mask will hide everything outside it. Now, there's not a lot of movement in this clip, so it was easier, but if the person moves, or the object moves, or the camera moves, then you would have to move the mask along with all the other movements in the clip by creating some keyframes. The new clip is on the timeline, and we have a connected text on top. You see, this one has a little movement in it. She's moving her head left, she's moving her head right, and so it's gonna be a little bit different than the last clip. With the text selected, double click the draw mask tool. That will put it directly in that text. Make sure this is selected and just start drawing again where you don't want the text to be seen. This time I'm gonna reduce the opacity of the text a little bit so that I can see the girl and the shape that the mask needs to follow. And by the way, if you don't see the drawing pan, just make sure that the position tool is selected. It's right here, or you can also just press P. Take your time with the mask, but remember to invert the mask so that it can display what's outside the mask. That's the difference between the first method and the second method, because now we want everything outside the mask to be seen. Also, don't forget to bring back the opacity. Okay guys, now let's create the keyframes. By clicking here at the control points, you can see it turned yellow. So that means the keyframe was created. Hopefully this tutorial is also good for beginners, and hope you can see where we're going and what we're doing for this effect. Okay, we're gonna move the playhead maybe 2 frames at a time. So we're gonna move the right arrow to move to the right. Of course, right arrow moves to the right. So just tap it 2 times, and you can see the girl moved a little bit. So our mask is not really covering the girl anymore. So adjust the mask a little bit and create another keyframe. And that's how you're gonna track the mask with the movement that is happening in your clip. And just keep on doing that until you get to the end of the effect. Okay, look at this. Of course, I didn't take my time to do this, but man, I don't like the result. I probably should have taken more time because of the hair. It's a tough selection to make too, especially manually, but that's the thing with Final Cut Pro. Masking a moving subject can be very tedious. If you're someone who likes to use this effect a lot, or you like doing any kind of rotoscoping, meaning that you want to isolate an object and move it or color it or whatever you want to do with it, make it bigger, make it smaller, I highly recommend the plugin mRotoAI from Motion VFX. It speeds things up 1,000 times over, and the quality is actually really good. Look at this clip. Let me show you guys. There is even more movement here. I'm gonna add the mRotoAI on a duplicate, and you're gonna see how fast this plugin takes care of this. Check this out. You can choose to manually draw a mask or use this magic wand tool right here by just drawing on the subject. I'm just scribbling on here, and it's so... As you can see, it's so fast. What's in blue is the selection. I'm gonna zoom in a little bit and use the magic eraser to take some of this out of the selection. Let's add a little bit of blur just to refine that selection so that it's not gonna be too rough. There we go. Once you're satisfied with the selection, you can just press the tracker, this tracker button right here, and track forward or backward depending on where your playhead is at. Bro, I told you it goes fast. Now let's look at the result. Maybe change the display to video so that we can see it without that blue, you know, selection. And boom, that's how fast it is. Link in the description, guys. I'm gonna do a full review of the Motion VFX Pro plan to see if it's really worth it. mRotoAI is including their Pro plan, so before you get it, make sure you also have a need for all the other Pro tools they have to make the price worth it. And that's it, guys. If you got any value from this one, subscribe and check out these other videos for Final Cut Pro users. Yeah, and you might like them. And I will see you guys in the next one. Hopefully. Peace.